India celebrated its 76th Republic Day on the 26th of January. On this occasion, India's first indigenously developed tactical quasi-ballistic missile, Pralay, was showcased for the first time at the Republic Day Parade in New Delhi. Pralay, along with Nirbhay, BrahMos, and Pinaka, will become part of the Integrated Rocket Force, or IRF, a separate entity from the Strategic Forces Command, SFC. Pralay is reportedly in the same category as Russia's 9K-720 Iskander, China's Dongfeng 12 CSS X-15, the United States Precision Strike Missile PrSM, and South Korea's Hyunmoo 2. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes Pralay tactical ballistic missile. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Pralay, meaning apocalypse, is a canisterized surface-to-surface short-range ballistic missile (SRBM) for battlefield use developed by the Defense Research and Development Organization (DRDO) of India. The missile is an amalgamation of technologies developed for Exo-Atmospheric Interceptor Missile Prithvi Defense Vehicle (PDV) from the Indian Ballistic Missile Defense Program and the Prahar Tactical Missile. The reported aim was to equip the services with a tactical conventional missile designed for battlefield use. The project to develop Pralay was sanctioned in March 2015. By December 2022, the Pralay was ready for induction, reaching the milestone in 7 years. The missile enables the Indian Armed Forces to strike enemy positions and critical installations within battlefield zones. The Pralay missile measures 9.06 meters in length and 740 millimeters in diameter, weighing 5.1 tons. It's powered by a solid rocket motor with a propellant charge weighing approximately 2.94 tons. Pralay uses the same composite propellant developed by the High Energy Materials Research Laboratory (HEMRL) for Sagarika from the K missile family. This propulsion system allows the missile to deliver a warhead up to a range of 500 kilometers, depending on the warhead configuration. The warhead options for the Pralay missile include a 370 kilogram or 815 pounds high explosive fragmentation warhead, or a 700 kilogram or 1,545 pounds PCB or RDPS. Penetration cum blast PCB warhead is designed to penetrate hardened targets or targets buried deep underground, such as military bunkers. Runway Denial Penetration Submunition (RDPS) is a specialized anti-runway submunition warhead capable of deploying 10 high-penetration bomblets. Guidance for the missile includes a Rings 16 inertial navigation system combined with millimeter wave radar for end-stage digital scene matching corrections. DRDO has reported a circular error probable, or CEP, of less than 10 meters, and work is ongoing to improve accuracy to a CEP of less than 4 meters. The missile reaches terminal speeds of Mach 6. Pralay is reportedly designed to evade interceptor missiles. The Pralay's edge lies in its quasi-ballistic nature, allowing it to follow a low trajectory while retaining the ability to maneuver during flight. The thrust vector control using jet vanes helps carry out evasive maneuvers during the terminal phase. Pralay can also deploy decoys to distract air defenses. These capabilities make it difficult to intercept, even with advanced air defense systems. Multiple trials, including the last one in November 2023, confirm the missile's operational range, payload capacity, and guidance capabilities. The system is road mobile and meets the tactical ballistic missile requirement of the Indian military. The twin launcher configuration allows for the consecutive launch of two missiles. It's mounted on an Ashok Leyland 12x12 high-mobility vehicle, replacing the earlier Czech-origin Tatra launchers with an indigenous design. Future Transporter Erector Launcher, or TEL, developments will involve BEML. It's made to respond quickly on the battlefield. Deploying to launch can happen within 10 minutes. Transition time from command to launch is 60 seconds. The excellent mobility will enable hit-and-run operations. Pralay's characteristics make it a potent weapon. The Indian Army has 250 on order, whereas the Indian Air Force has 120 on order. India's deployment of missiles along the Line of Actual Control, or LAC, and Line of Control, or LOC, is a strategic measure in response to the military capabilities of neighboring countries, particularly China and Pakistan. Both nations have enhanced their air defense systems near these borders. For instance, Pakistan has inducted the Chinese-made HQ-9 surface-to-air missile system along the LOC, and China has deployed similar systems along the LAC. Pralay can engage targets such as radar installations, command and control centers, and airstrips. It fills the gap of a conventionally armed ballistic missile that's not hampered by no-first-use nuclear policy. The Pralay has also garnered international interest. The Indian Ministry of Defense has approved its export, with reports suggesting advanced negotiations for a potential sale to Armenia. Export variants are being tailored to meet international regulations, capping the range at 300 kilometers or 186 miles, and the payload at 500 kilograms or 1,100 pounds. This customization aligns with Armenia's defense needs, particularly in response to Azerbaijan's acquisition of the Israeli LORA missile system. India and Armenia have a history of defense cooperation, including the sale of Swathi radars and Excalibur precision artillery shells. So, Pralay could act as a revenue-generating source, which could help with its further upgrades.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.